Good evening, everyone. Today we are going to do a bit different as yesterday. We are going to do some live coding on Filament Juno. And yeah, let's see how it is going. Well, the intro was running. I just noticed the stream is 720p, so I'm not sure what the cause of that is. Unfortunately, that's not something I can fix now anymore. So I am afraid we will have to live with that, unfortunately. I will check it after the stream what the cause of that is. I have no idea. I'm pretty sure I did set it up right, so I have no clue what's the cause of that. It might just be my iPad, actually, because I do notice it is. So yeah, I have no idea. So what we are going to do today is, like I said, a bit different as other streams. Basically, what I want to do is look into getting links from Filament Juno, the site, working if you use them to the app. So if you have a URL something, you can just scan that URL or go to that URL, and it goes to the app directly. So that's what we are going to try and get working today. Let's see how everything is going. I've never done it. My Android programming isn't the best. I can do it, but I'm not a full-time Android programmer. So let's see how this is going to work, and let's see if we are going to get it done this evening. So basically, let me go to the right tablet here on the screen and make sure everything is set up correctly. This is going to be a great stream, I already know. So let's switch to the computer. Basically, and so there, I'm also visible. I have no idea what's up today. So basically, what we are going to do is follow this small tutorial on the Android website, on the developer side, trying to get it working in the app. I probably will be starting actually with the manufacturer's page, and so not yet directly with the with the actual inventory page. The manufacturer's page is probably a bit easier. So basically, what I do want to happen when you have a link somewhere to this page, for example from ColorFab, that if you scan that link, that it goes to the app automatically. So that's what we are going to try and get working today. So I have never done this, so I hope everything is going to work out correctly, and we are going to try and get everything working. If you have any questions or any suggestions, please let me know in the chat and I will try to answer them. I do have the chat open, so hopefully everything will work. So the first thing is we need to start a tool. So let me grab Android Studio on the one side. And I do hope everything is readable on stream. So if it's not, again, please let me know. I'm using a pretty big window, so it is perfectly readable for me, but I have no idea if it is visible for everyone else. And I do notice there's a bit of noise on my... Yeah, it is. So I'm just trying to follow this. So hopefully it is not too boring. So we need to add a new URL, and the host name is filament.uno. And let me check that is actually the right path. So we want to use path prefix in this case. So everything starting with receipt goes to a different activity, and we want to use the yes, probably the main activity. Then we need to figure out there how this is going to work. So we are going to add this. It is adding a link to that. Yes, that looks good. So this seems to be perfectly. I'll test URL. Okay. And I do want the HTTPS version as well. So let me see. I only want the HTTPS version. Or maybe I want both. And I want the same activity, okay. So now we are, this looks right, okay. Then we need to get select activity and insert code. So it is doing it a bit at the end. We might want to do it a bit earlier because there's already a bunch of stuff going on here. No, actually, let's do it at the end. We don't need that. So we do now need to do something with this. So we probably are going like this, create a new menu. And then we are going to do handle intent, get intent. And instead of just writing it down, we are going to temporary lock it. Hopefully my keyboard sound isn't too much, but I do want to add to this log also the AppLink action, so I can see what is getting in. Okay, so let's first of all make sure this is actually building before we're going to continue. And I'm opening now. So if you haven't seen the app yet, basically you log in with your Fernament Juno account and you need to approve every action or before you can use it. So that's what I did. I am using in, or I am running in debug mode, but I am right now using live data. I switched it temporarily to use live data because that's a bit easier to do with live data for now. But yeah, you will see some, like for example here, this logos, those have a small icon to show. Yeah, you will see that on the live app version. And if you want to try the app, I have in the video description a link to the app itself where you can install it. So everything seems to work correctly. So we need to open digital. Okay, the site domain, that's right. Do I do want to do this? Probably not. So for now, we don't want to do that. Signing config, we are going to use debug. And what we now need to do is actually make sure this file is going to be online. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this, and it needs to be in a specific directory. So we are going to switch to PHP Storm, and we probably don't want to make it a Symfony controller because that's a bit too much. And it needs to go into dot well known. And there we need to create a new file, and that needs to be called asset links. And the system verifies via encrypted HTTPS. Yes, we only support HTTPS, so that's not a problem. We want to add it to Git, and then we need to copy it again here. And then we need to deploy this, so let me I don't want to do everything, I only want to do that. So, and we are going to push that directly to the server. And then we do need to deploy this. And luckily, that is pretty easy, especially if I have basically no changes. Oh, let me grab my security key. I am back in a minute. Okay, so I needed to have my security key. Otherwise I can't commit anything to Git. Oh, sorry for all those sounds. And now I just log into a VM I have here. And I can deploy this. So this should take a few minutes before it is deploying. Basically what it is doing right now, it is deploying everything to the VM or to the server, and it is using the last version of the pushed commit. So in this case, it's only one small change, but if it is a bigger change, it is basically the same process. And if everything is well, this will take around 3 or 4 minutes. And there will be no downtime at all for the site. So everything is done in the background, and once the process is fully done, then it actually moves over the site to the new version. And it is now doing some JavaScript stuff. I think this is the part that takes the longest. So we do need to wait a bit, and it's a bit unfortunate. Because the next step will require that this is set up correctly, so we can't do anything first. It is nearly there, it's now cleaning up the last things. And running migrations, so the database is up to date and there are basically no versions. So, and there it is done. So now we should be able to okay, so it doesn't work. So what did we do wrong? The directory. Directory name is right. File name is right. Interesting. It is not cached. Okay. I don't need to look in as root. Interesting, the directory is not there. I didn't expect that. Okay, I guess we are going to use some. We are doing it the hard way, I guess. So what we are going to do is make a service that is going to return this. So we are just going to add it under the home controller. And we are just directly putting in the contents, and then we want to use. Well, I do hate my sound sometimes. So basically, we just now made a new route in Symfony, very easy. And we don't want to commit everything again. We want to do that one, and that one. I should have used a proper commit message, sorry. So what we are going to push it again. And we need to I do wonder if I was just too fast. Let me check on GitHub if it is there now. Before we are going to do another try and there's no code there. So it is now there with this, yes. So we are going to try and deploy this again. And let's see if it is going to work this time. And while we are waiting, I'm going to switch to this screen. So basically, the whole reason I am doing all of this is basically because in the end, I want to be able from the Android app to link to Filament, or from anything to link to Filament inventory. And what I'm thinking, for example, is to be able to create QR codes of NFC tags. And from that, you can put that QR tag or the NFC tag on a spool of Filament and use that to scan your inventory. So you have on every row of Filament, you have a tag or a QR code. If you look at it, you scan the tag, you directly go to the inventory page in the app, and from there you can basically say, I printed 50 grams of that. And that makes the inventory even easier. So that is the whole end goal of this. We probably won't be able to get there the whole process today, but I do want to get a good step. So I do want to have at least the ability to link something. And if we do have time over, we will be going to try and link the inventory page as well. But because there are no public inventory links already, so we do need to make something for that on the site as well. So So we will see how far we are going to get there, and we will see. It will probably take a good few hours before everything is done. So I probably will split it up in multiple streams, and we will do the rest of it in the next stream, if we aren't going to be able to finish it today. And I do want to do these kinds of stream more often, but yeah, in most cases I'm not always in the mood to stream and also the decoding, and I do need to set up a whole bunch of stuff, so that's basically the reason I don't do it that often. But I will try and do it more often, depending how this goes. And it is nearly done, so we are going to switch back to the screen, and let me try to make it to up myself as well. There we go. And yeah, now you can see it. So it is done now. So let's see, that one. So now it is returning nice. And yeah, unfortunately it doesn't return as JSON. So what does it? I should have added. Let me do that. And then I won't be deploying it directly now. But I do want to tell that it is. This is returning a response, so I can just get the return value. Turn it after that, but. To the response that it is content type. This headers set content type is application JSON, and it is public because it is a public, and I do need to do that. Yes, so let's give it another try here and link and verify. So so we do need to deploy it, unfortunately. So it's saying you are hosting the digital assets file with our own content type. Yes, that is just what we fixed. So again, we do need to deploy this, unfortunately. So we are going to take another 5 minutes. And I hope, I'm not fully sure if in Symfony this is the right way to do it. So hopefully this will work, but we'll see that in just a bit. So again, if you have any questions during the stream, please let them know in the chat, or if something is not working correctly or something. So I'm going to wait a tiny bit. And there we go. So let's just switch again to this one. It is a bit boring to watch. Not that I am much more excited, but it's probably more excited to see me see a screen that's just giving a few yellow lines of code. And it also gives me the opportunity to make sure everything is working all right, and it looks like it is. Oh, we did break something. So let me switch here. So this is how a nice bit of errors come out. So let me see what's wrong. It failed. I'm not sure what failed here. Oh, I did break something. Oh, I. It is. I did commit everything now. Okay, so. Oops. So that. I did have some local changes that I didn't want to actually commit, and now I did. So we are now going to get a bit more changes on the site. They aren't great, or they aren't really interesting, but yeah. We will have them now as well. It are basically just a few updates to dependencies. And I hoped this was going to be a bit more easy instead of deploying a lot of stuff that I didn't want to deploy. So this looks better, it is going to the next step. Is installing all JavaScript packages that are required. And yes, this is always the boring part, waiting on deployment. And actually, when I'm looking to that site, which I am now, this main screen is boring, I'm actually looking at what is going on stream and making sure the stream itself is going okay. So I can see there what's going on the stream, basically. So I do see everything, all different camera angles and things like that. I can see on one monitor and also the audio and stuff like that. So it is a pretty simple setup. I am using a small ATEM Mini just to stream directly. So there is no PC involved from the streaming itself. So I just need to contact everything to that ATEM Mini. And from there I directly stream to YouTube. Oh, it went wrong again. So interesting. What did I change here? Well, this is not something I did want to change. It is interesting, I didn't change anything to the I did upgrade Symfony. Okay. Yes, let's see if you can fix this. So basically the site is still online. So yes, That is no problem. That is interesting. So it is. That class doesn't. Okay. So I'm going to try to run it locally to see if everything is working now instead of directly deploying it again. It is downloading stuff. Interesting, it is doing downgrading a bunch of stuff. Not sure why that's happening. Okay, let's see if it works, not that one. Okay, we have the same, at least we have the same error here, so let me clear the cache here as well. So again, this was not something I wanted to debug today, but yes, sometimes you need to do something unexpected. So it is still doing that. Let me check if the site itself is still working before I'm... Yes. So basically, the I did it right. But I do want to check. It is indexing. My PC is not really liking this. So, what I don't understand, how did this work in the previous version? I'm going to check one thing on the commit I did. Uh, I'm wondering. Yes, I don't want to go to doctrine tree. Okay. So I'm going to revert these changes actually. Yes. And in my composer JSON. Composer update, it's not in this directory. So not sure how it happened that this was updated locally. So let me see, it's downgrading. Yes, that looks good. And so with a bit of luck, if my SQL error because my database isn't running, yes, that's right. So I need to start the database to make sure it is right. And I do believe actually this fixed it, but I do want to see it now before we are going to deploy it again and it's not working. Yes, that looks like it's working. So we basically just downgraded doctrine common, as apparently they changed things in namespaces and things like that. And I don't, not great. So let's push this and then we are going to run our update again. So let's see if this is going to work now. Hopefully we aren't going to break anything. And the data stream is a bit low. Let me check. What is going on? Okay, this probably was just because the black color. Okay. I just was making sure. I did notice on the screen that the stream was only using 1 megabyte, and that is a bit low. But if you are just looking at a black screen, that is understandable. So it is deployed now, and let's see if the content type is now a bit better. Yes, that looks much better. You already see it, the Chrome did directly format it correctly. And let's see its application JSON. Yes, that's what we are expecting. So link. So that's perfect. So I think we can now go to the next step. Another thing what I want to do is I do want to add my the release key as well. So I'm going to check where my key store is. This is the same. Where are my templates? No, it's not the same. So what I do want to do is add this, and I'm not going to deploy it now, don't be afraid. But I do want it to make sure it is there for when I do deploy it. So, and I do need to remove that. Yes. So let me see what the next step is in here. So we want to click test app links in the link app assistant. So we are going to make this smaller again. Not with that one, but this. So let's try this run test. I probably made a typo. So run test. And it is installing the app. And so this is exactly what we want. So it looks like we got it working. So basically here it's asking now with what app we want to open, we want to open it. So we want to open it with Filament Juno, and we say for now just once. And it is saying loading data, and that's right. And I want to check if we did add some logging. So. I also noticed here in URL resolve, please link and verify your digital asset links. That is right. As far as I know, because we did check that. opening up from website. So that is basically what we wanted to see, yes. So this is right. So here we have opening app. So it is working, it looks like. We have here opening up from website, and with the app link action is Android View. So that's actually what we check here. So we want, instead of app link action, we want to show this, and then we want to stop the app, reinstall it. And interesting, we need to log in again. Okay. And then we need to test. Okay, so what we do get is a So what do we want to do now? We want to figure out what the last part is, and then we are going to need to have an API that checks which is the ID of that, because I think, and I will need to check it in the documentation. There is a nice set of documentation, if I remember the URL, of course not. It's always the same. It's our AP docs. So what we want, we have now the manufacturer. Okay. So we need to get the idea of a manufacturer. So this also means we will need to deploy the site. Again, of course. What we are going to make is in the app is an API controller, a manufacturer controller. So I want to copy that because I'm lazy. And we do need to name it post filament. Get manufacturer by name. And this will return a view. I can type today. It's return manufacturer by name of the organization. And we can copy that part. And we will add a name. And this should be it. And let's have a look at the local. So, and it's this one. Okay, so that's exactly what we are needing. We get the manufacturer data and okay. And what we actually just can return. Is a is name and it is a response HTTP. Okay, response yes. Okay, and I probably will just the problem is because those app links are configured for the main site and not for the local site, it is a bit hard to debug this now from locally. So what I'm going to do is just deploy this. And then we are going to write the Android code while we wait to this deployed. So let's push this. And it is pushed. And what we are going to do within the in the app is actually going to add the data that is needed, so we can actually get the data. And that is this get. And this is going to just and we need to do it like this. And here you can actually see I am combining PHP and Java at the same point. What am I doing wrong here? Yes. That is needed, Paul. So we are just over an hour in and basically we haven't done anything. Well, that's not true. We did make some things. But it's not good. I should be more productive. This is not returning a list, but just one. Okay. And that we now can use here. And what I want to do if receive I if and So interesting. Oh. That's not very handy. Where are we going to get data? Okay. Is it? Let me. Yes, so the API is there. That was actually pretty fast. So now we can start using it. I do need to check my phone for a minute. Yes, I did copy that code. I do sometimes hate how I have set up this code space. And we want to dare call get filament manufacturer by name, and then and yes, this is what you get from copying. I could also have just implemented it directly without copying it from somewhere else, but I'm lazy. I did make it. Okay. So let's see how this works. We need to stop it, build it. And the only thing we need to do after this is just go into the right page, and then we basically are done. And I think that will be probably also it for the stream today, because I don't want to make it a too long stream. We are now nearly 1 hour 20 minutes in. 1 hour 10 minutes. So that will probably be the last thing we do today. Oh, it did break something. Interesting. Okay, not sure what we broke there, but that's something for after we tried this. And we are again locked in it. Something went wrong. VNO fee not found. Okay. Interesting. Yes, we did break it. The main manufacturer is gone. And I wonder if it was because of the name change or the name duplicate name. So let me, I did change that now. So let's see if it's now there. Yes. Okay, so again, we need to deploy it. I do want to check why it is giving a VR04, so let me stop you. Interesting. How does this work? I don't know. I just assume it works. So let's push this. Wait, I'm just. Interesting. I did expect a log file. I do want to check this locally for a minute. Let me think how I am going to fix that. I'm going to get something to drink first. So I am back in a second. Okay, there we go again. Yes, I do want to switch to a local because I want to make sure everything is working right. We do need to hack this around a bit. First, we need to go here and enable this. And that will cause a problem in a minute, but it's fine. And what I'm going to do is, instead of just doing it sometimes, I'm just going to hard code it here. So. and only if in debug. So I can leave this code here if needed. I am going to log out, because otherwise we will have a problem. And let me switch myself to there at the bottom. I hope this is still my IP. No, 1 6. That should be fine, yes. It's taking a bit of time, but that should work. Not sure what's going on. Oh, I wait. I already know. I do need. I did stop that. Retry. Login. Yes, we. Approve it. Okay, object not found. That's good. Because we probably don't have a qualified name. As you can, you saw it is doing a lot of backend calls. What is it trying to query? Let's see. We do want to go to the homepage. And we want to do last 10, and then we want to have color fab. Doctrine. And it's trying to do it on based on ID. And that's not right. Cancel, cancel. Was like this. Oh. am I doing it? Oh, I can do it on Slack. Yes, I should do it on Slack instead of. So let's see if this is working. I want to stop it and run it again. It is still giving and not found. It's still doing it on ID based. Yes, it should work. I am going to add this. I need to import it. I'm not sure if I'm going to the homepage back, if it's going to automatically execute this. I don't think so. I'm able to refresh data. And as you can see, it is lots slower when running locally. But mainly because Symfony is running in Dybbuk mode, and that makes Symfony pretty slow, I would say. Pretty slow. And that is causing the problems we are seeing here. So it is not actually the fact that my laptop, my PC is slow, because it is a pretty fast PC. Right. So let's see. Yes, now it is working. It is interesting why I need to assign this, because it is working correctly in other places. I don't like this query at all. It will be fine, and there is only a handful of manufacturers. Okay, so this code now is working. Let me do some debugging and check what data we are going to get here. I want to debug this. Oh, we are already there. I do want to see a response. Ah, perfectly. That is exactly what we don't need. And what I want to check now is what I do in because I do need to switch tabs. Because, I didn't want to do that. So, if this is happening, we do want to switch to the manufacturer step, that's for sure. And we also want to do this. So, I want to see if I can do how is this called? This is probably pretty odd, yes. The problem is, I don't know enough about Okay, I can. Let me check. Because. What I basically want to do is this. And then I hope it goes also to the right tab. But I'm not particularly bad if it doesn't go to the right tab. So let's see how this is working. And we need to log in again. This actually is caused by me locally developing. So this should not happen, I hope, on normal builds. I'm not fully sure because I'm not running a normal build, but always a debug build on my phone. Okay, we got an exception. Okay. So we first need to yes. I have no idea. Navigation. You are a fragment. Okay, let's see if this works. So it's still giving a exception. Okay, I temporarily want to disable that one. I do want to check if it's going to the manufacturer page. Interesting. So basically, depending on how this is going, I do want to stop in around 15 minutes or so. So we probably won't be doing a lot after this. And yeah, depending on how far we are finished, we might not even finish this. And the 2 hour stream is yeah, probably the max I really want to do now. If you aren't able to finish something within 2 hours, it's probably not worth continuing, at least during the stream, to work on. I hope you understand. So this doesn't seem to work. Let me apply debugging. I do have it set up with enough controller, right? So instead of this, I can find enough controller. Navigation. Let's find enough controller. This. And then we can do controller and navigate. So we are going perfect. So that's step one. We are going to the correct page. So let's see if we are doing this now. And instead of probably doing this, we might also there are some things we can improve here. Basically, if we detect we are having data here, we should be able directly to go to that page instead of first trying to load the page we are at the home page. So that's something we need to fix. Another thing is we now need to first navigate to the manufacturer's page, and after that we can do the change. So that's not ideal. That is something we can fix. So let's try and fix that first. So that is going to be in my navigation file, and it's somewhere here. Mobile navigation, I think it is it. And then we want to have navigation manufacturer. I don't want to change anything here, Paul. Let me see if I can be able to understand this. So we want to copy this and at home. Instead, action to manufacturer list from home page. We want to go to the manufacturer row. Yes. And from the manufacturer row, we want to back to home implemented. Back to home navigation home, navigation home. Okay, this is a bit complex, but basically this helps by we are defining here how the navigation works within the app. And we have now added a step. Before, we are only able to navigate from the list of manufacturers there are to the list per manufacturer. But when we enter the app, we are at the home screen. So we don't want to go from the home directly to the, or first go to the manufacturer's page and then go to the manufacturer's list. So we need to make sure there is a possibility within our navigation from going from the home to the manufacturer detail page. So that's basically what we did. So now let's go back and let's finish it up, because now we have a new method where we should. And instead, where is my code? So we are going to copy this for now, but we are going upstairs. So we don't need the NEV controller because we already have the NEV controller. Only it is called controller here. The directions is something else because it is home fragment directions. It's not built yet. I think no, it was not built yet. Are you done now? Action to yes, and there we have the response punt body. And this is going to be the action. Interesting. Interesting that it is returning that. I expected it to just do what it does at other places, so basically just be this. Yeah, that's fine. And let's comment this out as well for now, and let's test this. And then we have 7 minutes left. And the last thing I want to check or to do is check if we do have some data. So if we do have the data from the or if we have the page, and if we do have that, we want to first or we want to directly go to there instead of trying to load the homepage. So what we are going to do is I'm going to inline this code. I do need to rebuild some of my code here. For example, I do want to start with this a bit earlier. And all this needs to be done. Fetch background information, starting to request flavors. Yes, that needs to be done. But it's interesting. I'm not sure. No, never mind. We are going to do that later. I was wondering what. Oh, of course. Yes. The home. Yes, so we won't be able to do that, unfortunately. It will always load the home because, yes. Okay. Bit unfortunate. It is not a really slow process, I would say. It is slow on my local host, but. So let's clean this up. Let's add a nil check here. And what I'm also going to do is quickly deploy this because I don't think we did that. Fix, bam. And then before we are going to stop the stream, we are going to test it live on the production side as well. I didn't see how it worked. So I want to see it's loading, it's knocking out again. And it's going nicely to QualiFab. Perfect. So that's working. I do wonder because that's a good question. If you are locked out and you are opening a link, this might be a problem because there is no, because we are sending it to a different activity. Yeah, I don't think that I'm going to, it might happen. I need to think about that. Let me create an issue for myself. So this is not something we are going to fix today for sure, but I want to make sure. I will check it at least at some point. So let's log out to clear the data, and we are going to force it to release mode. I'm going actually to force it just to release mode. And I do that here, force release mode. That's good. And what I want to do is clean up my main activity. And it should not do anything now because we are in release mode, but I don't want to leave this code here. Actually, now I think about this, we can implement this here very easily. So you have nav controller here and navigate to air.id. Navigation. Do we need to do anything? No, I don't think so. Okay. Oh, we broke a tin. Ah. This happens sometimes. Now we just need to run it again. So let's already try to log in. Oh, we are still root. I need to run it in this one. So, and let's hope it saved my password. It did. And as you can see, there is now here no mention of a debug mode or something like that. So that way we know it's release mode, it's using public data. And what I do want to do now is the tools, AppLinks Assistant, test AppLinks. And the one I want to test is the one without print test. Something went wrong on the server. Oh yes, that's we need to wait till it's deployed. Because we broke it earlier. So let's wait. So already before, now we are waiting. Anyways, let's make a short conclusion of this string. So basically what we have done today is we have got the Android AppLinks working for now, just for the manufacturer's overview page and the manufacturer's detail page. I think that's a pretty good thing for the 2 hours we have done. We had some problems with some unrelated stuff, but we fixed that pretty quickly. And I think this is a good start for getting it to work for the next part. So the next thing will be getting it to work for the page for the inventory for a user. So if you are scanning that it opens directly into the app. And I also would like to make a page on the site itself. So it will be two things. And that will be probably the next stream. Okay, I need to fix this by hand, I assume. So that will be for next stream. I'm not sure when that next stream will. I would love to do it weekly or bi-weekly, but I'm not sure if I'm really in the mood to do it that often. So I'm not going to tell or say any dates that I am going to stream. But let's try to do it every other week or something like that. And now let me see. I have no idea why this is going wrong now. So yeah, that, like I said earlier, it does require a bit of time to set this up, this streaming setup. It's not like easy. Well, it is easy, it's not hard, but it does require an hour of work or so before a stream and after a stream to clean up everything and set down everything. So I don't want to do it too often, but I do want to stream more, and I think the coding streams or Filament Uno are a great way to do so. Yes. I'm not sure if I want to do it every week, but we will try to do it every now and then, and I'm not going to tell, or I will try to tell a few hours before the stream when I'm doing it. And yes. Let's work out why this isn't working. And after that, we are going to go out a day for this stream at least. It did gave the same error again a few minutes ago. Let me move myself. So I'm not sure what's causing it now. And yes, unfortunately, it's taking a long time. Okay, so it is okay now. So let's try this. I'm going to restart the app. Yes, it is directly going to the manufacturer's page. So that's exactly how we want it. And the other thing we want to try is to go to the Colourfab page. So run test, and it's going to Colourfab perfectly. So that's exactly what we want. I think we had this was a nice stream, and yes, we had some problems, like I said, but yeah, I think it worked out nicely, and this will be on the App Store very soon, the Play Store, or how it's called now. And if you want to install the Filament Uno app, there's a download link in the description. And it's still a work in progress. It does work. You can change you can add new filaments, you can submit filaments, you can manage your inventory, but it is still very basic. But it will be improved in the future, and hopefully with you joining during the live streams. I would like to thank you all for watching, and hopefully see you next time. Thanks all. Bye for now.